Hey, what's up everybody? My name is Moss and welcome back to our tutorial series on Jenkins. Until now, we've only created freestyle jobs and Maven jobs in our Jenkins server. But in industry, you'll need more than a single freestyle job to facilitate your full build and release process. And for these more complex use cases, Jenkins allows you to define your build and release process in VIII. In this video, I'm going to introduce you to Jenkins Pipelines. Let's begin with a brief overview. As a team's software development process matures, it can become difficult to model the build and release process using only freestyle jobs in Jenkins. In order to mitigate the complexity of managing multiple freestyle jobs, the Jenkins Pipeline plugins allow you to model those complex build and release processes as VIII in what's called a Jenkins file. So what are some of the benefits of using a Jenkins pipeline? If we check in the Jenkins pipeline code contained within the Jenkins file into version control, then we immediately get the benefit of traceability and control over changes made to the pipeline. The other benefit of version controlling the Jenkins file is that the pipeline exists independent of a Jenkins server, which means if for some reason the Jenkins server was accidentally destroyed, the pipelines would not be destroyed since they're managed in a source code management server. The other benefit of Jenkins pipelines is that they are highly extensible through the use of shared libraries and plugins. In addition, pipelines support logical operators such as conditionals, loops, and parallel execution. Let's also quickly discuss some key pipeline terminology. The first is the concept of a pipeline. A pipeline is a user-defined model of a build, test, and release process for a software product. The second term you should be familiar with is node. A Jenkins node is a machine that the Jenkins controller can execute pipeline jobs on. The next concept that you should be familiar with is a stage. A Jenkins pipeline stage is a logical grouping of steps that typically align with the build, test, and release portions of the software development lifecycle. So for instance, you might have a build stage, a test stage, and a deploy stage. You should also be familiar with the concept of steps. Steps are individual tasks completed within a stage of a pipeline. For instance, a single step could invoke a Jenkins node's shell and execute a command like ls or make directory on it. It's also worth mentioning the two types of Jenkins pipelines. There are declarative and scripted pipelines. Declarative pipelines are a newer feature of Jenkins pipeline, and declarative pipelines have richer syntactical features than scripted pipelines, which makes them easier to read and write. Now that we have a general understanding of what Jenkins pipelines are, let's get started. Okay, so I'm inside of my Jenkins server, and the first thing that I want to do is install a new plugin called the Pipeline Maven Integration Plugin. Now, to write a Jenkins pipeline, you don't need any additional plugins. All of the plugins that you need to write a basic Jenkins pipeline are included when you install Jenkins on a machine. But if you have a Maven project that you want to build inside of a pipeline script, it's good to install the Pipeline Maven Integration Plugin because it adds some additional features to the pipeline. And we are going to build a Maven project later on in the video, so I'm going to go ahead and install that plugin. And to do so, I need to navigate to the Manage Jenkins page. And from Manage Jenkins, I want to select Manage Plugins. And I'm going to select the Available tab, and then I'm going to search for Pipeline Maven. And this pulls up the Pipeline Maven Integration Plugin. So I'm going to go ahead and select that, and I'm going to select Download Now and Install After Restart. And I selected the Restart after it's been, Restart automatically after it's been installed. So Jenkins is restarting, and once it's restarted, we'll be able to utilize that plugin. So now that that plugin has been installed, let's navigate back to the dashboard, and we're going to create our first pipeline job. So to create a pipeline job, I'm going to select New Item, and I'm just going to call it Test Pipeline Job. And then I'll select the pipeline item here, and I'm going to select OK. Now from here, I'm going to go down to the pipeline section, And we can define a new pipeline in the pipeline section. And we have this dropdown here. And the first selection is pipeline script. So we can define a pipeline script directly in this job definition, or we can define a pipeline script outside of Jenkins and version control it in an SCM tool like GitHub. We will use this option in our second example, but in the first example, I'm going to build the pipeline script directly in the job definition. Now, it's possible to write a pipeline script completely from scratch, but if you're not too familiar with Groovy or pipeline syntax, then it can be a little tedious to write a script by hand. And what's convenient about Jenkins is it gives us this tool, the pipeline syntax tool, to automatically build a pipeline script. So I'm going to go ahead and open up the pipeline syntax tool. And this tool allows us to automatically generate pipeline code. And we have two options. We have the snippet generator, and then we have the declarative directive generator. With the snippet generator, we can define individual steps. And remember that steps are individual tasks within a particular stage of a pipeline. And let's take a look at some of the steps that are available to us. So the very first step that we can do is we can archive artifacts. We can build a job that exists on this Jenkins instance. We can also echo, we can use the echo command to print a particular message to the console, and then we can enter the message here. Okay. And then when we enter the message or we fill out whatever parameters are necessary for the step that we selected, we can select generate pipeline script, and then this automatically generates the command that we would enter into the Jenkins file. So you would use the snippet generator for automatically creating individual steps within a pipeline stage. But if you want to define the overall structure and the stages of a pipeline, we would use the declarative directive generator instead. So from here, it gives us a sample directive dropdown list. And in this dropdown list, we can select various directives. And the one that we're going to want to use is the stages directive. So we want to define multiple stages for our initial sample pipeline. Once we've selected the stages directive, I'm going to add a stage. And the first stage that I'm going to define is the build stage. Okay, so this stage is going to be responsible for building the code base, whether it be, you know, a C++ code base or a Java code base. And the build stage is going to contain steps. So the build stage could contain parallel stages, so we could run other stages in parallel of the build stage, sequential stages, or a matrix. But in this case, for a simple pipeline, we're just going to have steps included in this stage. And then after specifying that steps are contained within this stage, I can also specify additional options. So for instance, I can specify that this stage should run on a particular subset of agents, maybe Linux Jenkins agents or Windows Jenkins agents. And then I can also add when conditions to the stage. I can add post stage or build conditions. I can add environment variables for this particular stage. So there's a lot of options that I can utilize in a stage. But I'm going to leave it as that and create a new stage. And we'll call this the test stage. And this will also contain steps. And then we'll create one last stage. And we're going to call it the deploy stage. Okay. So the testing stage, of course, would be the stage where you would test the code that was built in the prior stage. And then in the deploy stage, ideally, if the test passed, this would likely be a conditional stage. If the test passed in the testing stage, then you would deploy your changes to production, or maybe if you had like a QA environment or some sort of promotion process, you would initiate that promotion process. So these three stages represent the skeleton of a new pipeline. And to generate the code for these stages, I'm going to select generate declarative directive. And you can see here that it automatically generates these stages. Okay. So we have the build stage, the test stage, the deploy stage, and then within each stage, we can have one or more steps. So what I'm gonna do is copy this generated code into my editor, and I'm going to begin a new Jenkins file. So I'm gonna open up VS Code. And before I paste this code in, I need to define a pipeline block. So I'm going to say pipeline and then brackets. And directly under the pipeline block, I'm going to specify agent any. And what this statement means is that this pipeline can run on any available Jenkins agent. And then after the agent any statement, I'm going to paste in the stages block as well. Okay, so now we have our stages defined within the pipeline block. But right now, this pipeline doesn't have any steps defined within the stages. So let's define a step within each of the stages. So I'm going to use the snippet generator in Jenkins. And let's use an echo statement. So I'm gonna click echo here. And then let's just say, hello world. Generate pipeline script, and then let's copy this into our new pipeline script. All right, so I'm gonna delete this comment here. I'll paste in the echo statement, and here we'll say building. And then for testing, as you can imagine, we'll say that we're testing. And then same for here, we'll just say that we're deploying. And then we'll add one more to indicate that the pipeline is completed. Okay, so this should be a valid pipeline. So let's go ahead and copy it and navigate back to our pipeline job definition, and I'm going to select configure and go back to the configuration page. And then under the pipeline section, I'm going to paste the pipeline script into the field here. Okay, so let's go ahead and click apply, click save, and I'm going to go ahead and build the pipeline. And it looks like the build failed. So let's go ahead and open up the console output. And I can see here that it looks like it was expecting a closing bracket at line 23. So let's navigate back to the editor. And okay, it looks like I missed the closing bracket for the pipeline. Okay, so let's move that in one. Alrighty, and then let's go ahead and copy this updated script, and then we're going to configure again, and then we'll paste it back in. All right, let's go ahead and save, and I'm going to build again. Okay, and now the build is passing. And in addition to a passing build, you'll notice that this stage view also popped up after the build completed. And the stage view basically gives us an overview of what happened in any particular pipeline build. And it separates it out by stage. So we can see here the status of the build stage, the status of the test stage, and the deploy stage. We also can see the average stage times, which in this case, there's only one run. So it's the same as the current execution of this build. So it didn't take long, 391 milliseconds. These are pretty quick stages. And for each stage, we can see logs contained within that stage. And you can see our echo statement building in the build stage, and same for the test and deploy stages as well. So you can access the logs through this interface, but you can also, of course, open up the console output and see roughly the same, but maybe a little bit more verbose. So as you can see, writing a basic Jenkins pipeline script is pretty straightforward, but of course you want to build, test, and release code in a pipeline script. And in this example, we didn't have any code that we built, tested, or released. So let's go ahead and create a new pipeline, and we'll actually build a Maven project in our new pipeline, and we'll also utilize the Pipeline Maven Integration Plugin. And before we create the new pipeline job, I want to real quickly show you the GitHub repository that we're going to build. And it's this one, the sample Maven project. And it's a very basic Java application that just prints hello world to the console. And it has a single test class using JUnit. And in the single test within that test class, it just runs an assert true on a condition true. So the test should pass. And this is the same project that I used in earlier videos when we were discussing Maven jobs in Jenkins. So what we're gonna do in this repository is create a new file, and it's going to be a Jenkins file that contains our pipeline code, and we'll keep it at the root directory of the project. So I'm gonna select add file, create new file, and then we're gonna call it Jenkins file with no extension, just plain like that. And then we will define the pipeline block here. And agent any statement. Okay. And then we're going to automatically generate the rest of the pipeline. So let's navigate back to Jenkins and we'll create a new pipeline job. So I'm going to navigate to the dashboard. And from here, we'll select new item. And we'll call it test Maven pipeline. And then I'll select a pipeline and then select OK. And from here, we'll scroll down to the pipeline section. And for the pipeline definition, instead of defining the pipeline script directly in this field, we'll pull the pipeline script from SEM. So I'm going to select pipeline script from SEM. And then for the SEM system, we'll select Git. And then we're gonna specify this repository's URL. So I'm gonna select open a new tab, and I'll copy the SSH URL of this repository. And we'll paste that in. And it gives me an error code since I haven't selected credentials. So I'm gonna go ahead and select an SSH key pair that I previously created. Okay, so it looks like it authenticated correctly. And then under branches to build, I only have the main branch, so I'm going to update the branch specifier. And then under script path, we have to specify where the Jenkins file is located in the repository since we're keeping it along with the code base. And in our case, we have the Jenkins file at the root directory of the repository. So we can leave this as is. But if we had the Jenkins file in a subdirectory, we would have to specify that path in this field. And now we're going to define the actual pipeline. And I'm going to use the pipeline syntax tool. And I'm going to select a declarative directive generator. And I'll select stages. So I get a stages block, and then I'm gonna add a new stage, and we'll call it Maven install. Since within this stage, we're going to invoke Maven, and we're gonna run the Maven install command on our Maven project. So this stage will contain steps, and this is going to be the only stage that we really need, since Maven install is going to, you know, complete the full life cycle. So I'm going to select generate declarative directive, and then we get our stages block. I'm going to go ahead and copy this text. I'm going to navigate back to our Jenkins file in GitHub, and we will paste the stages block within. And let's navigate back to Jenkins, and I'm going to scroll up to the snippet generator, and we'll define a new step. And this is where the Pipeline Maven plugin comes in. So I can utilize a step called with Maven, okay? And then with Maven provides a lot of options. So with a specific Maven environment, I can perform Maven operations. So I can specify a particular installation of Maven or of the JDK. I can specify Maven settings as well. So there's a lot of options that the Pipeline Maven plugin provides. For this use case, I'm going to use essentially all of the default selections. And I'm going to scroll down to generate pipeline script and generates a very simple with Maven block. And I'll go ahead and copy that. And then I'll navigate back to the Jenkins file. I'm going to paste that into the steps section. Okay. And in the with Maven block, I'm going to invoke the SH utility. And then I'm going to invoke Maven. So I'll say Maven clean install. All right. And that should run Maven, perform a clean, and then perform the install lifecycle. And this should be all we need since the Jenkins file is stored with the code base itself. If the Jenkins file was stored in a different code base than the Maven project, then as an additional step, we would also have to invoke Git here to clone down the code base. But in our case, since the Jenkins file is in the same repository as the code base, we can leave it as is, and this is going to run Maven clean install on our Java application. So I'm going to go ahead and commit this. And let's go ahead and navigate back to our pipeline. And I'm going to select save. And then let's select build now. Okay, and it looks like the Maven install stage failed. And I get a message here that says Maven not found. So I think that the Maven installation might not be selected. So I'm going to select configure. And let's open up the pipeline syntax. I'll select with Maven again. And then with the Maven installation dropdown, I'm going to take a look and see. Okay, so I should have selected Maven 3. I have a Maven installation that I can specify. So I think I was supposed to select this. So let me generate the pipeline script. And as you can see, when with Maven is invoked, now the Maven installation is specified as a parameter. So I'm going to go ahead and copy this, and I'll add it to our Jenkins file. Okay. And then let's go ahead and commit those changes. Alrighty. And I'll navigate back to our pipeline, and I'm going to select build now. Okay, and it looks like the Maven install is working correctly. Okay, so just to kind of recap what I did, I specified the Maven installation that the pipeline should use when we invoked the with Maven code block. And if I take a look at Manage Jenkins, and I look at the global tool configuration, under the Maven section in Maven installations, I have a Maven installation that I install automatically called Maven 3. Okay, so this is what was showing up in the drop-down menu in the snippet generator. So I'll navigate back to our pipeline. And as you can see, when the pipeline runs successfully, the Maven installation command ran. And let's take a look at the output here. So the full lifecycle, the full install lifecycle ran. So it built the sample Java application. It ran the single test, and we can see that the test ran here with zero failures. And then we get successful artifact publishing to the local repository. And the local repository in this case is just the Jenkins workspace. So if I take a look back at the job homepage, you can see the last successful artifacts are the snapshot jar and the snapshot POM files that are contained with inside of the workspace of build 2. So these are the build artifacts of build 2. And from the build page, we can also evaluate the test results of the pipeline. In this case, there weren't any failures, and there was only a single test case that was ran, and it passed. If I take a look at the home page, we also get the JUnit, the test graph with the results of each build's tests. So as you can see, when we use the Pipeline Maven integration plugin, it makes writing a pipeline script for a Maven project a lot simpler, because all we need to do is specify that with Maven block, and then we can pass in parameters to the environment, the Maven environment that is generated by the Pipeline Maven plugin. Okay, so we were able to specify an installation as a parameter to the with Maven block, and we could run other installations of Maven as well if our Maven project was dependent on an older version of older or newer version of Maven. So that's pretty much all I had for this video. I hope you enjoyed it, and in the next video, we're going to continue our tutorial on Jenkins Pipelines. And if you'd like to read about Jenkins Pipelines, be sure to check out LambdaTest's Learning Hub for Jenkins. The Learning Hub has a lot of great resources related to Jenkins, and real quickly, I'll navigate to the Learning Hub and show you. So it's LambdaTest.com/LearningHub/Jenkins. And you have these chapters, which are separate articles on various topics related to Jenkins. And if you were particularly interested in reading about Jenkins pipelines, you could check out the Creating Your First Jenkins Pipeline article. But again, thanks for watching, and I will see you in the next video. If you'd like to learn more, be sure to follow our blog at lambdatest.com/blog, as well as our LambdaTest community at community.lambdatest.com. You can also earn resume-worthy LambdaTest Selenium certifications at lambdatest.com/certifications.